1945. The war was finally over, and we were all at this big party. People in the Bronx were happy as hell. Well, people everywhere were happy. The boys were back in the neighborhood, and I was happy because my best friend, Danny DePalma, was back from overseas. I wasn't in the army, and I kind of flat feet, you know. That's Danny in the uniform. Thing about Danny, he was an easy guy to like. See what I mean? He was always a little bit smarter than everybody else, and sometimes in a neighborhood like ours, that could be a problem.
Hey, listen, you never said anything about what went on over there. It was just the war, all right?
So, what did Rose want?
She just told me she was glad it was back, that's all.
You know, someday that girl's gonna make a wonderful grandmother.
Really,
I'm serious. You two even get an apartment, huh? Fordham Road, 3.5 rooms, very private bath in the kitchen. Hey, it beats living with your mom.
Hey, that's only temporary. I got plans. I was thinking, you know, make a score, move downtown.
Why? Move away from the Bronx?
Well, yeah, the Waldorf.
The Waldorf Astoria?
Yeah, 49th and Park downtown.
Yeah, I know where it's at.
They change your towels every day, Freddy, even if you don't use them. I think I'd like that, you know?
Towels? Hell, if they ain't dirty, why change them?
Danny. Danny DePalma!
Hey!
You uniform and everything.
Yeah.
How long you been back?
Eh, a couple of days.
Poor Harry J.B. double. Huh?
Hey, nothing changes, huh?
Not around here, anyway.
I hate punks. Hey, Harry. I'm real sorry.
Will you save that stuff for the ring, Walter? Not my bar.
Hey, I'll pay for the chair. I got a fight coming next week. Big money.
Just go home, Walter. Relax.
Hey. I know you. Danny, you're Joey DePalma's kid. Don't you recognize me? Walter Lagonegra. Logs, the boxer.
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, the Bronx cheers for Logs. Hey, I used to see you at my pop's old soda stand. Next to Gleason's gym.
Danny here's the smartest kid I ever met. He used to write poetry. Boy, was his old man proud of him. You still write poetry, Danny?
Eh, kind of. I write songs now.
Songs? Play me one.
Nah, I haven't practiced in a while.
Come on, play me one. Beautiful song I ever heard.
Why don't you just call Paulie? He'll take you back.
Paulie?
Pepper, no salt. He doesn't like salt.
I don't want to be a painter, all right? I don't want to paint houses, Mom. I'm telling you, I want to be a songwriter.
Danny,
Oh,
it's all right. Yeah, I'm gonna be sorry.
Coming, Papa.
Of course I am.
You wanna be a what?
I wrote all the songs for the Army shows, Ma, and everybody loved them, okay?
Where's the butter?
You wanna make up songs?
Yeah.
Puccini just didn't make up songs. Rossini didn't just make up songs. Danny, you're not one of them.
Look, Ma, a songwriter can make a lot of money, all right? I'm telling you, you get a hit record, you get royalties. I can make a bundle, Ma.
Yo, Danny! Hey, Denaro!
What is it, Freddy?
Come on.
All right, hold on, all right?
Come on. Let's go.
Hey, square.
What are you doing?
What?
You're screaming up at the window with my mother and everything. What kind of
I'm sorry.
Have some respect, all right? And look at you. You look like a bum, Giordano.
Okay, will you come on? Will you cut it out? Listen, we got to go over to Gleason's gym. Walter wants to see you.
Walter, who? The boxer?
Yeah.
What does he want with me?
Don't ask. Just come, will you, please? Huh? Is it a favor to me? Come on, let's go.
All right. Hey, Freddy, come here.
What? Your boy's in the back.
What?
He's probably knocked himself out by now.
Oh, your boy?
Yeah, I manage him. I manage him on account of he put his last manager in the hospital. Thanks, Freddy.
You're welcome, Beth. Anytime.
But he don't ever touch me, right? So I collect 10% for being his friend.
Oh, hey. What is this about, Freddy?
Bova wants Walter to take a fall.
Oh, you mean throw a fight?
No! Throw a fight, no! Yes, and he's pissed off.
All right, so why am I here?
Walter says you're the only guy in the entire world who understands him.
I don't even know this guy.
I know, listen. I just thought maybe you can calm him down a bit.
Calm him down?
Yeah, you know, talk to him. Just calm him down.
Do my best. Okay.
Good. Come on.
Judy, you know the rules. No women in the locker room. Come on, hit the bricks.
She stays.
Okay.
Why'd you say something?
That's enough, Walter. So, what are you banging your head for?
You want me to go in the tank, Danny. I ain't laying down for nobody anymore. I'm gonna hit this big stiff so hard, I'll kill his whole family. Understand, don't you, Danny? Everybody thinks I'm a bum. I'm no bum. I'm a good fighter, right?
Of course you are. Logs, now you feel. You feel like winning. We all feel like winning. You know why? It's because so much of life is losing.
So much of life is losing. So much of life is losing. You're right, Danny.
Hey, what's one little loss? There'll be other fights. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. All that matters is how you play the game.
How you play the game? Jeez, Danny. You're right. No, you are a genius.
I don't know how you do it, but it works. I mean, Walter, you know? He trusts you. And believe me, he's a good friend to have. Like me. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Get that word yet, Harry?
Yeah, scapegoat.
Danny. Come here, I want you to meet my girl. Danny the Palmer. This is Judy Schwartzbaum. She's Jewish.
Yeah, I think we met in the locker room.
Yeah, what do I know? And this is a big man in the record business who owes me a big favor, Milton Gold.
Publisher?
Yeah, glad to meet you.
I listen to the show all the time, the radio show. Milton Gold Presents, huh?
Yeah.
Danny here is a songwriter. He wrote the most beautiful song. Go play your song so Milty here can buy it.
Let me buy Mr. Gold a drink.
That's a good idea.
Hey, I want Milton to hear the song.
Walter, come here. This might not be the best place for it.
I mean, piano's a little out of tune. We wouldn't want Mr. Goldier out of tune now, would we?
No. Hearing it out of tune would not be good. You're right, Danny.
But maybe we can meet in your office.
Yeah, kid, why don't you give me a call? I'm downtown in the Brill Building.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Gold. Hey, thank you, Walter.
Don't thank me. Thank Judy. She said I owed you on account of you saved me from cracking my skull against the wall.
You are?
My name is Danny De Palma. I have an appointment with Mr. Gold.
He is?
My name's Lars Lagonegra, the boxer. Your boss owes me a big favor, see? Some wise guy was into him for a couple grand and he wasn't paying up, so,
let's just say I got his attention.
Come on in, boys. Yeah. How you been? The piano is over there. Let's hear what you got, kid.
All right. It's a little love song I wrote. It's called Don't Cry.
Lousy title. Go ahead, play it. Play it.
Don't cry as we say goodbye. Just for a little while.
Hello, Milton Gold. Instead, haven't put up 30,000 copies.
Let's leave words
unsaid. Yeah, Crosby's gonna sing it. Go ahead, kid. I'm listening.
Remember your smile.
Yeah. No. When I get in touch with you, right? I'm gonna do it on my radio show, too. No. The girl singers are gonna do it. Yeah, don't stop. I'm listening.
Don't cry.
Yeah, Milty, how can you talk on the phone and listen to my friend at the same time? Jerk.
The hell do you think you're doing? You crazy son of a...
Pay a little more attention to my friend, Mr. Gold.
Mr. Gold, I apologize. Walter, he can use the phone. Come on, I think we should go, okay?
Danny, let me handle this.
Security, get off the ground, nuts!
I'll show you who's nuts, Milty. I'll show you who's nuts, Milty!
You crazy son of a bitch, Walter!
I'll show you
no,
who's crazy.
Please,
I'll
no!
I'll show you who's crazy.
Get the hell out of here! Take your garlic breath with you!
Garlic breath?
Oh, big deal! Walter, no!
Garlic breath, huh? Ah, huh, Mr. Gold!
What are you doing?
I stole records! Jesus, not the French drain!
I'm sorry!
Ah, Mr. Gold!
I'm sorry!
Get the Michigan out of here!
Let's go!
Yeah, come on! Yeah.
You're never gonna get your songs published anywhere. You're blacklisted in the music business as of today, forever.
Let's go.
Danny, listen. I want you to think of this as one giant canvas of yours. You understand, sweetheart? Paint the corners and the edges outward exactly 3 1/3 inches. Wait a second, what is this?
What?
Annie, I told you we're getting paid by the hour. You see the difference? Here, kid. Go get it. I'll be back.
Steph KO'd Walter tonight, third round. I know what's wrong with Walter lately. He destroys people, but not in the ring.
Yeah, well, maybe he's got stage fright.
Maybe he's a jerk.
I didn't say that.
No, genius, I did.
You know, I was thinking with your Ayla.
Oh, go ahead.
Your hair like that? It makes you look like Veronica Lake.
Walter, huh?
Took my licking too. You wanna dance?
Alright, I got paint all over me.
It's alright. Could use a little touching up.
Criticize me, but I'm going to do just as I want to anyway, and don't care just what people say. If I should take a notion to jump into,
let's go somewhere else.
Ain't nobody's business.
No, I don't think so.
If I do.
Why? Because of Walter?
Judy, I'm his best friend.
You're turning me down for Walter. Do you realize that?
I thought I'd find you here.
Ain't nobody's business.
Don't tell me. Walter wants to see me.
Alone.
I'm sorry, Julie.
Hey, Danny. Maybe he's your best friend. Did you ever think of that?
Nobody's business.
So what do they want from me? I laid down, I threw the fight, just because I broke that big stiff's nose?
You weren't supposed to hurt him, Walter.
So I gotta lay down again tomorrow night? The Bronx cheers for logs. Well, not after two losses in 1 week, they don't.
They pay you good money, Walter.
Hey, fuck the money.
Okay.
You know what I mean, Danny. A guy can't keep stinking the house out and have any self-respect. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure, Walter. I understand. Hey, but look at it this way. When you go out there and you take the fall, I'll know why you did it. Not because you're no good. Hey, but because you had to.
Not because I'm no good. Because I had to.
All right.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you care what everyone else thinks, huh, Walter? Am I right?
Right.
I mean, what do you care? Look, I know you can lick the guy. You could kill all those guys, right?
Right.
So you go out there and you collect your money. Make them happy. And you and I, we're gonna laugh about it, right?
Right?
In private, huh?
Yeah. Let's do a laugh about it. Hey, Danny. You're my best friend.
Walter, have a nice chat.
Look, Judy, about what happened back at Harry's,
Hey, forget about it. You know, a year ago, he was having a great time. He was winning fights. He wouldn't have wrecked that publisher's office.
He did it because he likes me.
He wasn't treating me bad.
He was protecting me. And if I was really his friend, I wouldn't have told him to take the fall. He needs a win.
Yeah, it's been so long, I don't think he'd even remember how.
No. He'd remember how, believe me. I just gotta tell him the right thing at the right time. He remembers how to win.
Yes?
Yeah, I'd like to see Mr. Gold.
Haven't I seen you here before?
No, not really. Probably someone who looks like me.
What's your name?
Benny Goodman. A junior.
What the hell are you doing here?
Mr. Gold, please.
Get the hell out of here! I told you were through in the music business.
No, just a minute. Now look. Look, I'm here to apologize and to make you a lots of money.
How?
Well, Walter told me about the favor you owed him.
So what's that to you?
Nothing. But it means you're a gambler. And I got the hottest tip in town, Mr. Gold.
What do you want for it?
Just a chance to get my songs published. Lagunegra's fighting Tiny Hawkins in the Tremont Arena in the Bronx tonight. Look, the odds are on Hawkins. It's a fix.
So what do I want with low odds?
You don't. You're gonna bet on Walter. See, the money's on Hawkins because Walter's been losing. But Walter's gonna win this one in the first round by a knockout.
How do you know?
Bet it. Don't ask.
Finally. I thought I told you 7:30.
My
mother? I thought we were going to get a babysitter.
What was I supposed to do at last minute?
Oh, come on. We're going to have fun.
These things, will you? Let me help you.
Hey, gentlemen, I'm looking for Lars Lagunegra, the boxer, you know?
Oh, yeah, he's in the dressing room back there.
Wait a second, which way?
No,
that way. No, which way?
That way. Yes,
thanks,
Lars. Hey, kid, come back here.
Hey, Walter, you want to lay off of the booze?
Okay, Mick.
Danny, glad you could make it. I'm about to go out and take a dip. Easy, Mick, easy.
Enough bloody booze, Walter.
Then me and you will go out and have a good laugh, right?
Yeah, sure, Walter. Hey, Freddy. Hey, Walter, I was just thinking, what's the worst they could do to you if you won?
Nothing.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. That's why they pay me so good to dive. You know what I'm gonna do with this week's money? I'm gonna buy some new white walls for my car. Next time I go in the water, I'm gonna take Judy to Cuba. Hey, Danny, why don't you come along?
I don't think that'd be such a good idea, Walter.
Why not?
Because you don't want me to be around Judy.
I don't.
I think you better go now, Danny.
Okay, why don't I want you around Judy?
Because the other day, I was looking at Judy, and I was thinking, I bet she looks great with her clothes off.
Huh? You thought that?
Yeah. So you know what I did? I told her what I thought. I started touching her and feeling her. She said I had great hands. I mean, it was the best feel I've ever had in my whole life.
Danny, I think you better take your seat now.
I want you to sit down.
Now, take it easy, Walter. Take it easy, lad.
What'd she do?
She kept telling me to stop. She said you were the only guy she let touch her.
She did?
Yeah, Judy, she's great. Judy.
All right, come on, Walter, let's go. Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah, but that didn't stop me.
Judy said that?
Yeah, Judy said that. What are you, deaf? What are you, stenods?
Judy said that.
Listen to what I'm saying. I want to steal your girl. I want to take her away from you. I want to kiss her. I want to take her dancing. I want to take her to Cuba. I want to make you a chump.
Chump?
Take it easy, Walter.
Hey, Danny. You're not my best friend anymore.
Walter! You are crazy! What are you even drinking in here?
Walter, me and Judy, huh? Me and her.
Protect yourself at all times. Pull your cards.
Just relax, I mean, trust me. Walter, I'm gonna do this to Judy in Cuba. Yeah, that's right.
Geez.
We're gonna do the rumba. That's right, Walter, we're gonna go do the rumba in Cuba, me and Judy. That's right,
there
that's
goes
right.
The bell. Round one is underway. Logs comes out like a truck. There goes Hawkins' nose.
Come on, Truman!
Another right, a left to the jaw. Logs is destroying him. This is mayhem. Hawkins is down.
Judy,
7, 8, 9, 10, go!
Knockout in the first round.
Call my office, kid. First thing tomorrow.
Hey, Danny. Looks like the Bronx is cheering for Walter again.
You got it, man. You got it.
Thank you.